ओके सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट दिस इज योर 11th साइंस ओवर हियर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द 11th साइंस बायोलॉजी द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न. इट इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर, इट इज द बेसिक चैप्टर रिगार्डिंग योर 11th साइंस एंड इन दिस पोर्शन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इट अबाउट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. इट इज बीन टर्म्ड एज इन सेल स्ट्रक्चर and function. So here we are going to discuss about the basic chapter as you have studied in your past standard also. But that is not a simple one. This is not a simple portion. We are going to learn these things into a deep matter. Cell structure and function. In these we are going to learn the structure of the cell and what is the function of the cell. So let's start from the basic mechanism about the living being. As you know that we are studying over here one of the best portion that is termed as a biology. When we split this word, it is divided into two part. One it is a bios plus logos. Here the term bios means with life and logos means with what over here study. So here we can see that the study of life, it is termed as in what over here? Biology. And most of the students should have these characteristics to learn the father of biology. As we see the father of biology, we can call it as an Aristotle. So the Aristotle is the father of the biology. You might be thinking that why the Aristotle is been termed as a father of biology? Because when we see that during the first time of a period, the Aristotle used to dissect several kinds of fishes and to see its anatomical structure. And he has written something in case of his literature about these, all the anatomy, the physiology of fishes. So hence, the biology were being started from studying those days, and due to that reason, we call the Aristotle as the father of biology. When we start the cell from the basic study, so each and every living organisms are made up of a specialized kind of a system over here, and we are going to start from the atom. So the atom is working as the basic part for each and every living organism. The atoms are going to combine with each other, and when it moves about, we are going to directly move to the biology only. There is a formation of molecule. So here the formation of the molecule is going to be taken place over here. And more specially, the molecules which are formed, they are termed as a biomolecule, biomicromolecule and biomacromolecule. Both of them are there, but we are not going to study both of them now. We are going to study in a later on different chapters. So the atoms are going to form the biomolecules over here, and these biomolecules which are going to form, they constitute and they are going to form organelles. The organelles are going to form. These organelles combines and it is going to form one of the basic structure of living organism, the living entity. We call it as a cell. From the cell, the structures which is going to form over here, from the portion of cell, we can call it as a, there is a formation of tissue. Tissue constitute and combines and it is going to form a different specialized structure over here. It is going to be termed as an organ. And from an organ, there is a formation of organ system, like reproductive system, like respiratory system, digestive system. These are all the systems within a human body. And from an organ system, the next structure which is going to form, it is termed as an individual. The individual is going to form over here. So you can see that this is the whole hierarchy, the classification, the arrangement of living organisms. But we used to always start our variety or our arrangement from these basic part of what over here, cell. So how we can define the cell over here? The cell is nothing. The cell, we can just write it over the definition of cell. The cell can be defined as the structural, and functional unit of life. So the structural and the functional unit of life, it is been termed as what? Cell. So cell is the basic meiotic. The cell is the basic component for each and every organism present on these part, on these universe. So cell acting as a main component. Main theory is going to be produced by what over here? Cell in this case. Now see, let's start from the brief history about the cell. What do we know in case of history? One of the scientists who was there, it has been termed as Antony van Leeuwenhoek. In the around the year of 1664, around the year, I don't know exactly, but around the year of 1664, one of the scientists comes into the picture named as Antony van Leeuwenhoek. What the Antony van Leeuwenhoek has done, listen carefully, that he has taken a rain water. When the rain used to come, the water which is gathered outside the ground, he takes that water. He has prepared a small and a simple microscope by himself. So what happened is, the water which has been taken by Antony van Leeuwenhoek was observed inside the microscope which was been prepared by him. And by looking it carefully, he has found out the small structures are being observed, the floating bodies. Some of them were rounding structures, some of them these kind, some of them are rod shaped. These kind of a structure he has observed. He has named this structure as an animalcules. These are been termed as an animalcules. But later on, when the research were been done in a modern condition, these animalcules were nothing but these are what over here bacteria. This is where the bacterial cells are. So this is the animalcules and the bacteria are going to be formed inside these in case of. And this was being characterized by the first one, by the Antony van Leeuwenhoek. The Antony van Leeuwenhoek was the first scientist to observe a living cell. Remember, he was the first scientist to observe what? A living cell. Then after what happened, another scientist comes into the picture. It is been termed as Robert Hooke. So the Robert Hooke has taken a outer bark of an oak tree and he has also prepared his own microscope and has observed the bark and he has found it out that the small structures were there, these kind of a small hexagonal shape structures were found. So these structures which were being present over here, he has given a name of these structure as a cell. So he was the first scientist to give the name to these structure as a what over here, cell from the plant. Next to this case, the another scientist later on comes into the picture, and the scientist name will be Robert Brown. So Robert Brown was the scientist who first find it out that inside the cell there is a presence of small body. And these small body, what is been termed as a nucleus. So the nucleus was been first discovered by whom? The Robert Brown. Then later on the scientist came in the picture over here, a Scriddan and Swan, Matthew Scriddan and Theodore Swan within this case. So what happens over here, the cell theory was being proposed. This has been termed as a cell theory. So what about the cell theory? The scientist, first scientist which was being termed, it is termed as Matthias Scriddan. If we say that the Matthias Scriddan, by a profession, he was a botanist. So here we can see it out by the profession, what was he? He was having the, or he is the botanist in these. And what does the Matthias Scriddan, the cell theory in the sense of what? The cell, how the cell plays a basic conceptual role in case of living organism. So in this case, Matthias Scriddan by a profession was a botanist and he has looked at different organs of plant. Plant also has the organ like root, leaves, stem, flowers, fruits, these are the organs of plants. So by observing the different organs of plant, he has seen that what the Matthias Scriddan has described over here, each organ of plants is made up of different tissue or a different cells. So each organ of the plant has a different kinds of cell within them. In case of the another scientist, it is termed as a Theodore Swan. The Theodore Swan, by a profession, he was the zoologist. So by the profession, he was the zoologist over here. And what does the Theodore Swan has observed? That when he saw the plant cell, he observed, or sorry, animal cell. Let's see, this is the animal cell over here. And inside this, there is a location of nucleus. Which cell is this? This is the animal cell. So what he has observed, that surrounding the animal cell, a specialized border is being present over here. And these border, we used to call it as a cell membrane. Or we used to call it as a plasma membrane. In case of animal cell, it is having a boundary of a cell membrane. But when we look to the portion of what? To the portion of plant cell, he has also been observed over here, or he has also been observing that another more layer was being present. Let's see, this is the part of a plant cell which was being present. This is the nucleus. The cell membrane was already there. But surrounding the cell membrane, another hard, tough layer which was being present. This hard, tough layer which is being present over here, it is been termed as a cell wall. So there was the presence of what over here? The cell wall was being present surrounding this part. And these cell wall gives a protective structure to the plant cell. So what you have learned over here, that in case of animal cell, it is only surrounded by cell membrane. But in case of plant cell, it is surrounded by what? It is surrounded by the cell wall. So this is in case of plant cell. So here, these are the two different structures which was been given by what? Theodore Swan. So the cell theory was initially proposed by Marcus Cladden and Theodore Swan. So hence we call it as a cell theory given by Cladden and Swan. What was the two initial point which was being given by Theodore Swan and Marcus Cladden? The first point of a cell theory, cell is the structural and functional unit of life. This is itself a definition, that the cell is the structural and the functional unit of what? Life. Next to these, the second case which was being given, it is important, each organism is made up of cells and its product. So the each organisms which are present on these universe are made up of cells and its what over here? Products are being formed. But see, these two scientists were not able to know that how does the new cells were arises, or from where does the new cells are going to form. So what another scientist, one of the famous scientists comes into the picture, Rudolf Virchow. What does the Rudolf Virchow has been telling you? Rudolf Virchow was the first scientist to see that from where does the new cell came. So what happened, let's take, this is the mother cell. This is the case of mother cell. And from when the mother cell is been divided, the two daughter cells are going to form. So one, we can see that this is the daughter cell. So here we can note it down that the two daughter cell comes from a single mother cell. So Rudolf Virchow has given the third point of a cell theory, that the new cells are coming from pre-existing cells. So here, new cells comes from pre-existing cell. So this was the cell theory given by the Marcus Cladden, Theodore Swan and Rudolf Virchow. And what does this say, is that the cell is the structural and the functional unit of life. Each organism is made up of cell and its product, and this new cell comes from which cell over here? Pre-existing cell. So this was the characteristic feature of a cell theory. And now we are dividing the various kinds of cell which are being present. Initially, the cell is divided on the basis of presence and absence of nucleus. So let's have a division of cell over here. What happens in case of the cell? This initially the cell is divided into two different parts. The first kind of a cell, it is been termed as, and I think so you have heard, prokaryotic cell. And the another kind which is going to come, it is termed as a eukaryotic cell. On the basis of presence and absence of well-developed nucleus or another thing. So see over here the prokaryotic cell. Pro equals to primitive. And karyon, it is termed as a nucleus. The primitive kind of a nucleus is there. And in case of eukaryotic, U in the sense of modern. And karyon, it is been termed as a part of a nucleus. So the modern kind of a nucleus is present with it. So in such of the cases, you can see that the prokaryotic cells are having a primitive nucleus and the eukaryotic cells are having a modern nucleus. So from these, we can write it down another point also. No membrane bound nucleus is there. No membrane bound nucleus is going to present. In case of eukaryotic cell, we can mention over here have membrane bound nucleus. They are going to have the membrane bound nucleus within them. Apart from these, they do not have organelle. I think so you have studied about the Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, chloroplast, endoplasmic reticulum. These are what over here? These are the a simple part of organelle. And they are having a well-developed part over here, organelles. And more other things are going to be present. So almost we can see that both of these cells are divided into various portions. So in these, first of all, we are going to learn the structure of prokaryotic cell. And then we are going to move about the structure of eukaryotic cell in these cases. So the prokaryotic cells are having a primitive nature. They are a simple structure. We are going to see one after the other. And then we are going to see eukaryotic cell. As an example, in a prokaryotic cell, there is a presence of what over here? All the bacteria. And in case of eukaryotic cell, there is a presence of plant cell, animal cell, all the animal cells, protozoal cells, yeast, fungus, algae, all of them are involved inside what over here? Eukaryotic cells. Okay, so dear student, let's start studying with the basic priority of a first cell that we are going to learn. It is termed as a prokaryotic cell. So we are going to deal with the first portion over here about the prokaryotic cell. And we have discussed at the end that the pro in the sense of primitive, karyotic in the sense of what? Nucleus. The primitive kind of nucleus is present in case of these cells. When you look the prokaryotic cell, we can see it out that it is having the outermost three protective layers. So let's look at carefully that how many layer protective structures are formed over here. This is the first structure which you can observe. This is the outer first layer is there. These first outer layer which has been formed over here, it has been termed as a capsule. So I am writing over here, this has been termed as a capsule. And these capsules, it has been made up of glycocalyx. So it is having the manufacturing part of glycocalyx, a polysaccharide is there. These capsule, it is a slimy, mucilage, a sticky substance is there. Next to these thing, on the inner one, that is the another layer which is going to present over here. This is the inner second layer. These inner second layer, it is the hard structure and it provides strength to the cell. And these inner structure, it is been termed as a cell wall. The cell wall of the bacteria, it is made up of peptidoglycan. This has been made up of what over here? Peptidoglycan. And peptidoglycan is made up of two different kinds of component. Out of them, the one component, it is an amino acids. It is also having an amino acids within it. And the another kind of a component, component which is going to be present over here, it is been termed as a polysaccharide. Or polysaccharide you can also call it as a sugar. So here the two different kinds of component is there, the peptidoglycan, one of them it is the amino acid, and another one there is the presence of sugar. The inner third and the last layer which is going to be present over here, these innermost third and the last layer which is being formed, it is been termed as a cell membrane or a plasma membrane. This is the cell membrane, or you can also call it as a, this is the presence of plasma membrane. So in this case, this is the outermost three layer. From the outer side there is a capsule, second one there is a cell wall, and onto the inner side there is a cell membrane. Here inner side to these there is a location of cytoplasm. So here this part it is been termed as a cytoplasm. One thing I would like to note it down over here, that the cytoplasm it is present over here, which is present over here, it is semi-solid in nature. Why semi-solid? You might be thinking that why not completely solid or why not completely liquid? Why it is semi-solid in nature? So the answer we are going to look when this topic is going to complete. So here there is a cytoplasm is going to be present over here. Inner side of the cytoplasm here, there is a presence of a genetic material. And as a genetic material, there is a presence of what? DNA. So there is a location of DNA, or we can call it as a, this is a genetic material. So here, these genetic material or the DNA, it is also been termed as a genome. It is also been termed as a genome. And it is located at the center portion of the bacteria. Apart from these genomic DNA, a small circular DNA is also going to be present. This is the small circular DNA which is being present over here. And these small circular DNA which are being present over here, they are termed as a plasmid. So it is termed as a what over here? Plasmid. This is the part of the plasmid over here. Next to the case of the plasmid which is going to be present, apart from the plasmid, onto the inner side there is a location of small bodies are there. The small structural part of the bodies are going to be present over here. And these small structural part of the body which are being present, they are being termed as a ribosome. So here the ribosome are the non-membrane bound organ. Non-membrane bound organelle. These non-membrane bound organelle or the ribosomes which are present having two different subunits are there. One it is the bigger subunit and one it is the smaller subunit. The larger subunit which are being present over here, it is been termed as a 50S. And the smaller subunit which are being present, these are the 40S. Here the term S, it is for sedimentation coefficient. So this has been termed as a sedimentation coefficient. You might be thinking that what is this sedimentation coefficient? So look at carefully. Take a plastic bottle over there, filled with the water, and add a large amount of salt or a sand into it, and mix it vigorously. And now what you are going to do, you just kept that bottle onto the table as a static condition. After some time, what is going to happen? That soil particle is going to settle down. So the speed of settling is been termed as a what over here? Sedimentation. A larger particle settles faster and the smaller particles are going to settle slowly. So on the basis of that, which component settles faster, the scientist termed as a spread bulb has given a unit, we call it as a 50S and 30S. But what happens when you combine both of them? It forms a structure bigger and smaller, and it is termed as in 70s. Do not add it up. Why? Because when Svedberg has found it out that when these single component were put, it gives a 50s. When these component were put, it gives 38. But when both of them were joined, it provides what over here? 70s component. So this is the characteristics feature of about what over here? Ribosomes. And ribosomes is made up of two component. One it is a protein plus another one which is going to come. It is the RNA. Now see on the back side of this, as a locomotory portion, there is also the presence of some component as a locomotion. So what happens in case of the locomotion over here? Locomotion in the sense of what? Movement, changing of place, motility. At the back side of this, there is a presence of a specialized kind of a system over here. This part, it is termed as a basal body. It is a basal body. The basal body is attached to the another portion over here. And this has been termed as a hook-like structure. So this is the hook-like structure is going to be present over here. So this part, it is been termed as a hook. And with this portion of the hook, another structure is going to be added over here. And this has been termed as a what? Filament. So here there is a structure which is going to be present over here. It is termed as a filament. Each of these, basal body, hook and filament, combines and it is going to form over here flagella. They are going to form what? Flagella is going to form. What happens, most of the student thinks it out that the flagella is going to rotate back and forth so that it can swim. No. This flagella shows a rotational motion. As you have seen that in case of giant steamers, when it goes on the water, the propeller of the steamer rotates, and due to the propelling of that propeller, the water is thrown backside and steamer moves forward. So same mechanism takes place. Due to the propulsion of these flagella, the fluid or medium flows backside and the bacteria moves frontal. The flagellas are how many? Only 1 to 2 over here. Apart from these, you can see it out that a small hair-like structures are also going to be present on the whole surface of the body. These are the hair-like structures. And these hair-like structures which are being present over here, it is termed as a cilia. The characteristics feature of cilia, it moves back and forth. It moves back and forth as like a swimming mechanism so that bacteria can move forward. Flagella is either 1 or 2 and has a complex structure, while cilia are many and located throughout the structure of body. Now see, inside the cytoplasm as a storage reserved material, there is also the presence of some kind of a storage compound, the storage of glucose, and this has been termed as a glycogen granules. Glycogen granules. There is a presence of glycogen granules over here. Apart from these, it also has a phosphate granules. So there is a presence of phosphate granules also going to be present. The glycogen granules there over here. Next to the glycogen and the phosphate granules, another component, the sulfur granules or the sulfate granules are also going to be present over here. So these are the structures of a granule and these are the reserved food materials. One thing apart from these, all the structures of bacteria, there is also the tube-like structures are also present throughout the whole body. A smaller and the bigger tube-like structure is going to be present over here. And these smaller and bigger tube-like structure, it is going to form pili. So there is a presence of what over here? Pili. What is the function of pili over here? We have to see it very carefully that what is the function of pili and how the pili is going to help to the bacterial cell. Let's see. I am showing you the two bacterial cells. This is the first bacterial cell. And it is termed as that it is having a genomic DNA, and apart from these, it also has a plasmid DNA. Hence, we used to call it as a what? F+. So, those bacteria which are having pili, they usually produce, or those which are F+, they usually produce pili. And another bacteria is going to be nearby of these, that is having genomic DNA. But it does not have a plasmid DNA, hence we used to call it as a what? F-. One is the F+ and another one is the F- DNA. So now what happens, once the conjugation, once the attachment, first attachment takes place, So the pili forms a bridge between both of these cells. So the pili is going to form a bridge over here. Now what happens in such of the cases, a one strand is going to cut over here and this strand moves over here and comes over here. So this is the first strand which is going to come and place over here. So as you know that the DNA is having two strands, one is the outer, one is the inner. So outer strand has passed over here and inner remains over here. DNA also have a capacity to regenerate itself. So one strand of DNA can produce its new another strand. So what happens over here? This is going to prepare the inner strand and this is going to prepare what? Outer strand. And now these F minus also becomes what? F plus. And this process, it is termed as an what over here? Conjugation. So this process of transferring a genetic material between two bacteria, we used to call it as in what? Conjugation. Here the shape which you have observed of a bacteria, the bacteria also exists a varieties of shape. So let's look at about the shape of bacteria. So what happens in case of a shape, the first kind of a shape which is going to come, it is termed as an bacillus. Bacillus in the sense of which kind of a shape? A rod shaped bacteria. So these bacteria are almost about rod arranged. And example we can write it over here, it is an Bacillus megatarea. This is the characteristics of Bacillus megatarea. Example, if you would like to remember it out, then it's okay. If you didn't able to remember, then it's also okay. The second shape of the bacteria, apart from the bacillus, which is going to come, it is termed as a coccus or a spherical. What happened in a coccus or a spherical bacteria? They are having a small spherical structure. They are spherical structure. An example we can write, it is a streptococcus. The coccus can be in a tool also. Diplococcus, and it can be in a form of four also. So this is the characteristics of coccus shape. The third one I am just putting at above surface, so you can look at very carefully. The third one, it is been termed as a spilium, or we can call it as a spiral shape. It is a spiral shape. So what happens in case of the spiral shape, it is having in a 2D, it is having this kind of a shape. But when you look at 3D, it is in this kind of, as like a spiral ring. And one of the great example of these, we can write it Rhodospirillium also, but I am placing spirochetes. The spirochetes are those bacteria which lives inside the teeth of a human being or an animal. And the last kind of a shape which is going to come, the fourth shape, it is termed as a vibrio. Vibrio in the sense of coma shape. Which shape is going to come over here? The coma shape structure is being formed. And one of the example which is going to come, it is termed as a vibrio colony. The vibrio colony which has been present is having this kind of system. This was the shape of a bacteria. Apart from the shape, we can also call it about the nutrition. So here, that is a case of nutrition. So in case of the nutrition, the bacteria exhibits a variety kind of a nutrition. The first kind of a nutrition which is going to come, it is termed as an autotrophs. Autotrophs in the sense of what? They are photosynthetic in nature. They prepare their own food. Next example, you can take it about blue-green algae, cyanobacteria or Nostoca and Anabina. They are photosynthetic and they are autotrophs. Next to these case, heterotrophs. So what happens in case of the heterotrophs? They do not synthesize their own food. They depend on other. So in case of the heterotrophs, we can place it over here. First one, parasite. They depend on other host organism for the nutrition. Next one we can call it as an, apart from these, saprophyte.
If I write this is the host requirement and saprophyte, they lives on the dead organic matter or dead matter. Dead matters of plants and animal is occupied by what over here? Saprophytes. Some of the bacteria are such that they take up the chemical material and they synthesize their own food. Those kind of bacteria is termed as a chemoautotrophs. They are the chemoautotrophs. So we can write it over here, organic compound is present and from these organic they prepare the food. And some of the other one is there which prepares or which takes inorganic compound like hydrogen, iron, nitrogen, sulfur and they prepare the food. They are been termed as a lithoautotrophs. These are the lithoautotrophs. So this was the simple summarical part about the shape of bacteria which you have seen. The bacterial cell, we have taken the cross section of bacterial cell and we have looked it carefully, and this was about the nutrition. Okay, so dear student, we are going to start with another drawing, another cell over here, and in another cell we are going to see it over here, that is in the case of animal cell. This is a part of animal cell that we are going to look it over here. Let's see what happens in case of animal cell. When we draw the animal cell, we can look it over here. This is the outermost boundary structure which you can find. And these outermost boundary which has been present over here, it is termed as a cell membrane. Or we can also call it as the part of plasma membrane. So this is the cell membrane or the part of what over here, plasma membrane. Now as we move inside, this is the location of cytoplasm over here. As we see, and at the basic concept, the center portion, the centermost region, there is a well-developed nucleus. And inside this nucleus, there is a presence of chromosome. This is the portion of what over here, chromosome, and it is surrounded by what? Nucleus. Apart from these, there is also the location of what? Nucleolus. So, if we see it out, this is the portion of nucleus. Or, these structure is a nuclear membrane. A whole apparatus which you are observing, it is nucleus. Inner side to this, there is a location of chromosome. And, onto the inner portion of chromosome, there is a nucleolus. Nucleus, chromosome and nucleolus. On outer portion, we can see that a net-like structure which has been present over here. This is the net-like structure which has been observed. And these net-like structures completely extend to the portion of what? To the portion of plasma membrane. Like this. So this is the outermost structure which we can find it over here. And these portion, it is been termed as an endoplasmic reticulum. But see, when you touch this surface, when you just fill it out this surface, you can find it out that it is completely smooth. Hence, it is termed as a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. It is been termed as an SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Another different kinds of reticulum is also being present inside the cell over here. So these reticulum is also playing a spatial and the auspicious role over here. So this is the auspicious role. The another, you can see this is the same only, but onto the upper surface of these there is a attachment of ribosomes. So there is a attachment of ribosomes are going to be present, and these structure which is being formed over here, it is termed as a rough endoplasmic reticulum. This is the structure of RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum is present. Apart from these rough endoplasmic reticulum, the animal cell also has a structure of these shape. And these structures which are going to form, they are been termed as a mitochondrial mitochondria. This has been termed as a mitochondria, which has been termed as an or which is acting as a powerhouse of cell. It gives energy to the developing cell. Next to this portion, we are also having one of the important apparatus over here, and this is the tubular structures are there. And these tubular structures, which is being formed, it is termed as a Golgi apparatus. So they are been termed as an what over here, Golgi apparatus. This is the Golgi apparatus. There is a presence of mitochondria over here. These animal cell has another structure surrounding it, and these another structures which is being formed, it is termed as a centriole. So it is been termed as a what over here, centriole, and which helps in the process of cell division. Apart from these, another structure, a proteinaceous filament like structure which gives shape to the cell, and these portion that is been termed as a microfilament. This is the portion of what over here, microfilament is present. And a small vesicles are being bulged out. These are the small vesicle having the enzymes or material inside this, and these small portion, it is termed as a lysosome. Zome in the sense of body, lyso in the sense of lysis. These are the body which helps in the process of lysis of something. Hence, the name is been given as the lysosome. So you have seen that this was a simple structure of animal cell, and these all portion, it is a semi-solid cytoplasm. Why semi-solid? You might be having thing over here. So one thing I would like to note it down, that a semi-solid plays an important role. If a complete liquid would be there, if a cytoplasm would be completely liquid, then there is a chance that these organelle might sink downside. If it is completely solid, then there is a chance that it can brittle, it becomes brittle. And as you know that this is a semi-solid in nature, so that's why it does not becomes breakaway and the organelle does not sink solid. So they remain on the upper surface only. Hence, the cytoplasm is in which nature over here? These are in a semi-solid nature. So this was the simple structure of the initial portion that you have been studied over here, and this is the part of which cell over here? Animal cell is going to be.